This is the Microsoft Sidewinder Force Feedback Pro Joystick, and I'm going to show you how to make an adapter so you can use it with a USB port in Windows 10. You need a microcontroller like this one, a Teensy 2.0 that uses an Atmel Mega 32U4 chip, and this guy will be plugged to the DB15 port of the joystick via resistors and wires, so you can convert the signal received to a USB signal that Windows can understand. The diagram that shows all the connections and the list of materials are available in the link below. I used a female DB15 port, or game port, two 2.2 kilo-ohm resistors, two nanofarad capacitors, which are marked as optionals but were required in my case for the adapter to work, and one 220 ohm resistor. The Teensy I bought came with no pins, so I had to solder them into the microcontroller to use it with the breadboard. I'm not going to show you the soldering, but there are plenty of YouTube tutorials that show you how to do it. The hard work now is to connect the pins as shown to the ports using different wires. I had measured them and cut in the correct sizes previously. Now I'm just going to connect them according to the diagram. So connecting the ground to the ground and VCC to VCC. In my case, I used a different color for each pin and assigned them as black for ground, red for VCC, orange for 2, white for 3, yellow for 7, green for 10, blue for 11, purple for 12, and brown for 14. The pins in the game port are as follows: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now we just have to connect each color to the correct pin. Now we simply have to connect the mini USB cable and we are ready to program. I tried to miniaturize the circuit using a soldered board and put it inside a mint tin, but it ended up looking quite sloppy. You can see here that there is a lot of room for improvement, but for the tutorial I'm going to use it as it is. The mini USB port already has a cable to connect my PC, and the joystick port we have to connect to the joystick. Now we just connect the USB in the PC to load the program. To program the TinC, you need to download the tinc.exe file from their website. You also need to download the hex file you are going to load into the microchip. Once it is open, you have to open the hex file you are going to program. The one that worked for me was the Adapt FFB Joy R54 that is available on the link below. Then you need to physically press the button on the TinC board as shown. Now we can click on Program and then Reboot. After closing the program, just remove and reinsert the USB cable and Windows will recognize the controller as a LUFA joystick with force feedback. Clicking on properties, we can see all the axes and buttons. And you can see here that they are working fine. I am testing the joystick here in IL2, which is a great game, by the way. And you can see that it's phenomenal. The controls are very smooth and very accurate, and the force feedback is exceptional. You can feel the plane resisting to your movements, you can sense when it's about to stall. In some games you can see sense the runway. It's very nice, each plane has its own characteristics and response. So that's it. That is how you can use these now cheap but awesome joysticks to play any modern game on any modern computer. So, see you next time. Bye bye.